All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back once again now to the StarLadder Star Series Season 14. This is Titan versus Hellraisers. Currently, Titan holds the 1-0 advantage. Please currently ignore what's at the top of the screen. This is not map number one. We're going actually on to map number two, which is going to be Overpass. So, Dust, let's talk a little bit about this.
Yeah, I mean, it's not a map that Titan really plays a whole lot. They've only played it really a handful of times, especially since Scream joined the team. But they do have a couple of recent wins. I think they had a recent win against Greyface in this tournament, as well as the one against Na'Vi over in ESCA. But they've also had some pretty big losses, but mostly to elite teams like TSM and Fnatic. So it seems like the only time they really struggle on this map is when they play against kind of the best of the best on the map, so to speak. Obviously, we saw Hellraisers, though, with a pretty big win earlier today, also against Greyface. And it was their map pick, after all, so they must be feeling comfortable on it. But yeah, I mean, I think that this is probably a pretty even matchup on this map. I could really see it going either way. There's a chance for Hellraisers certainly to push this to a map 3 off of this overpass, but also equally as much, I think, Titan could 2-0 this year.
So we are going to get started now, guys, with the pistol and some aggressive movements here actually coming out from the CTs. STYKO, along with Oskar, actually both moving down over here inside of the connector area to try and look for some kills. Not going to be able to find anything just as of yet, but this big push coming over there towards long A, they don't even see this coming as of yet, so this could be a big surprise to these, because they don't actually have anybody on the A site right now. They're just rotating up, so they're going to have such little notice of this coming in. I think they expect it to some degree, because they haven't found anything anywhere else, and kUcheR... Wow, again, kUcheR starts us off strong here by picking up Existence, but then Smith just come right back down and finds two kills right after this. He's going to find a third as well as he takes out Angel, and that leaves only two alive from Hellraisers.
Yeah, that's crazy stuff. I mean, there was a good initial hold there from kUcheR, and there was a quick flank coming in from Hellraisers as well, but Smith just dominated with three kills before the flank could really come into position to really have any impact on the round, and now it's just going to be STYKO left in a 1v3, the bomb ticking away. Yeah, I mean, he doesn't have a kit or anything like that either, so I mean, this round will likely go on to Titan, even if he can get the impressive three frags. He's doing a lot of damage here, whittling down Smith very, very low. Trying to find this kill, finally finds it, but again, the time is against them, and in fact, it'll just be a frag coming in from shox to end it, and there you have it, Titan starting off with the pistol round.
And now Titan again get a good start, and it's a good thing that they start things off here on T side as well, as again, you can obviously talk about this for days on end, but with it being a fairly CT-centric map, being starting off here on the T side allows you to pick up potentially, you know, three rounds right off the bat for free. So it's a great start here for any T side to work with, and Titan specifically here too. So they're going to buy up, pretty usual buy, two rifles, three SMGs sitting behind it. And then for Hellraisers, they go for the second round investment, pretty light on most players. Oskar does go for the Nova buy, try and work something in here at connector. Unfortunately, won't really get the chance to do so, so I imagine this one to be a pretty quick one in the favor of Titan.
Yeah, they're just swarming into the B-bomb site. Little resistance there. RPK just racking up the cash here with the MAC-10 already paid for itself with those two frags, plus some. Also one coming in from shox as well, so getting a little bit of cash, just trying to see if they can't rack up some extra dollars going into those gun rounds. As you said, this can be a tougher map on the Terra side, one of the more CT side of maps in their rotation, so Titan being able to get the 3-0 start is certainly a good sign for them. As we see STYKO getting one little frag there, and Nova still in Oscar's hands. They're looking for some exits, and they can maybe put those guns to use next round. They can survive, but great start from Titan.
At this point here, as you said, the members of Hellraisers is really just looking for those exits and nothing else to add on to this one. Oskar sitting behind, hoping somebody chases STYKO. STYKO really trying to act as the bait at this point, and it works out. Maybe going to get a shox, but he expects that player to be there. So shox is going to be able to take him down before anything else is traded back. Everybody else from Titan should be able to stay alive at the end of this.
The 2-0 start here from Titan, and little to work with here for Hellraisers on this next round as well. They weren't able to really retain anything except for that Deagle. Nova was not able to carry over to this round. So they pick up a couple of nades, upgrade a few pistols here. Maybe they look for some type of push play, some type of nade stack, since they do have the three nades. And we do see a lot of them heading over towards B with those nades, three of them in fact. So maybe we'll see some type of stack there. And STYKO actually find a 1-deek there on the screen to kick things off, and he's able to get away without being traded. So it's a decent start here from Hellraisers on this round to try to make something happen.
Shox too, rolling back in there. He's going to be able to catch kUcheR as these players are trying to rotate up to A, and this is going to hold back the rotation too. Pops out, finds a second, knows where the location of a third is, playing this a little bit more cautiously just in case we do see Schneider upsetting, but finally running out of ammo, switching to the USP, is going to be able to execute there in order to take out those players. And now once again here for Hellraisers, down to just two left alive at this point. Not a whole lot, once again, that they'll be able to do on a round such as this to really stop the inevitable here. We will more than likely see Titan just close this out nice and easily. Shox looking for one of these final kills. He's going to grab it. And STYKO down here, too. He just gets that nice little gooshing headshot, finishes it off.
An ace.
And that is going to be an ace indeed for Shox.
Kind of a, I guess, uneventful ace for the most part, but I mean, that was really well done from him. I mean, STYKO gets that initial 1-deek, so you think, okay, Hellraisers has a 5-on-4, there's a chance, but any hopes that they would have had of trying to upset that round were immediately crushed by shox, just putting a big push onto the B site, you know, cutting off people who were, you know, quick to try to rotate when StYKO spotted so many numbers over at A. He just cuts them off and winds up wrapping up the round with an ace. And so he'll actually keep that back 10 as well, so we'll try to see if he can't keep racking up dollars with it as Titan, looking for a really, really quick B split here, it seems like.
Trying to move their way in. A lot of smoke's coming in here. You can just see all the orange strikes coming back in here. Shox holds a connector to bar off the rotations for now, but his team is having a little bit of trouble there. They worked their way in, but they very quickly correct that, of course. Smiths and Angel trading out those blows. Existence finds the extra moment so far has not been traded out. And Angel, he's going to catch fire there. Goes to hell this time. And that's going to be Shox moving back out to pick up one of the final kills, too. So a quick closeout from Titan, and they're already up to 4-0.
Man. You didn't have to get all spiritual and say he was going to hell, Blue. I mean, it's just the kind of Counter-Strike here, man. There's no need for that.
His name's Angel. He's sitting in fire. It's
You made a good point there.
Gotta be edgy, man.
Gotta be edgy, right? And I mean, that's just a big display from Titan, right? They just sweep through the B-bomb site. Shox cutting off the rotates at stairs. Great smoke wall to isolate players over in a monster and just kind of, you know, cut off the rotation from being able to set up any type of crossfire with their teammates. And that just allows Titan a lot of favorable engagements, which they keep winning. And Shox just keeps rolling around with this MAC-10. He's gotta be near 16k by now. I mean, he just keeps getting kills and he hasn't, you know, upgraded at any point.
So Existence is gonna accidentally take that RPK in the process of all this going out too, so it could have been a lot better for Titan, but they actually are evenly traded. The unfortunate thing is that we don't really have a whole lot of upgrades coming up, and Oskar does try to flank them, but he's very quickly taken down by Existence, so now these guys are going to, once again, put themselves into a good position. Smith is probably the most vulnerable player out of the entire team right now, and if Angel gets himself a good angle against Smith, he might be able to take him down, but as these guys press their way forward, nobody's checked it as of yet, so there's StYKO catching one of these kills. Angel is going to get quickly taken down, and now they already know where StYKO should be playing this from, so they just got to hold the angle, essentially, at this point, and then they could have an easy close out of the round.
Yeah, definitely. StYKO has a chance here. I mean, he has a deagle. We've seen that thing be able to produce, so we'll see if he can't make it work. And so he's looking for some engagement here. He gets inside the smoke here, just trying to see if he can't find something. He does find the 1D, in fact, onto Existence, but takes a heap of damage in the process, giving Scream a little bit of an easier time. But if you can find another headshot angle and land it, it could work, and he does! And there you have it, StYKO with the deagle, making things happen, securing Hellraiser's first round of the half, and a round you probably didn't expect it to happen.
Best part about that too is I'm not exactly sure when he picked up that AK, but I'm pretty sure that happened actually before he killed Scream. So he has his AK, he could have technically switched this, but no, he just wants to finish it up with style with the deagle and just shuts it out with that gun anyway.
Yeah, I mean, that was really well done there from him. Just, you know, being able to work around the smokes. Scream and Existence weren't really set up to trade there, so he's able to find some one-on-one engagements with the deagle and win them. So big round there from him. He had a couple of rounds where he had some deagle kills, but he finally actually closes one out all the way. But still plenty of money on Titan, especially with as much dollars as Shox has been racking up with that MAC-10 in the first four rounds. So it's not really a burden on their economy just yet, but still kind of a surprising victory that Titan was probably not expecting to forfeit. And we'll see how they respond, as they're just going to be a lot slower this time around. Just kind of spreading out the map, kind of working picks here, not looking to quickly, you know, hit something this time around.
kUcheR sitting back over here onto the B site once again, too. Probably going to catch a lot of heat very early on. And might get the actual take itself in, too.
Weird, they're leaving kUcheR alone at B. They have two push bathrooms in lower park and one bank, and then StYKO playing the corner at long A. So they're very heavily set up for A. They have a quick rotate with Angel and Schneider, but that still means Titan overwhelm the B bomb site for free and get the plant.
Now as he's going to press their way onto the site, there's Oskar finding the first kill over here. Takes down Scream. He's got a good angle onto his second. He's going to find it playing way back, too. You could see so there's very little room for a response on Titan for that one with a position. StYKO gets that one tap on a Smiths, but now Titan, they're going to be able to pick up some frags here, too. Shox and RPK find two. Angel holding for construction, though, finding an additional one. And then kUcheR comes in with a closer, able to pick up the final frag on a Shox, takes him down. And Hellraiser does even prevent the plant there as well, I do believe.
Yeah, I mean, Oskar was really big there with the op. I mean, obviously, Hellraiser is way out of position. They stacked A, but they got the quick rotate. Oskar gets the kill on the bomb planter. The way the bomb fell forced Titan to actually have to re-peek Oskar to collect the bomb, which gave Oskar basically a free second frag. And that was kind of the big deal there, was just how he caught the bomb planter, how it allowed him a second free frag, and that really just kind of bogged down Titan in a big, big way. So Hellraiser is quick to respond despite being out of position, and they still secure the round. Now they have two in a row. And Titan, you know, starting to struggle here a little bit. Still plenty of money, but they're starting to lose some rounds here.
And Angel has spotted some of this play back over here, sitting inside a construction water area, so they know that there's a presence there. They don't know how strong it is just as of yet, as Titan, again, still playing back over here with Lower Park, and then now shipping their players through Connector once again. So they're going to roll right back in. They're going to try the same thing as last time, in hopes that it can succeed on this attempt. Things unfortunately did not go very smooth previously, but also looking at actually more people from Hellraisers naturally at least sitting into this site, so it could get a little bit rough, but the pop flash is perfect. It completely blinds kUcheR. They're not going to spot him on the way in initially here, but very quickly he's going to get decked to the floor too. Scream finding Angel, RpK catching out kUcheR, so there's two already dead to the ground. The rest of the defenders have been pushed off, and unfortunately for Hellraisers, nothing they can do about this. They just have to save because they're far too far away in order to get a rotation in time.
Yeah, this time around, Titan's able to actually get some kills here, and Oscar's unable to really make an impact with that op rotating. This time, Hellraiser's out of position, just like in the previous round, but because Titan's able to actually get some kills, and no one's able to actually like fall back and play a retake, they're able just to go ahead and lock this one up. And so Titan quick to respond the two rounds of Hellraisers. Hellraisers' money, still pretty low. Had to do a good bit of rebind, so they're trying to hold on to these guns. Oscar doing a great job holding on to that op in the playground, so this round will end in Titan's favor, but at least Hellraisers hold on to a pretty good amount of utility to bring over to the next round and still pose a threat.
So, now again here, Titan having a very, very strong lead. Jump over those two round victories from Hellraisers, and this is going to allow them to at least get one more round because of how Hellraisers have sort of shut down some of these attempts. But after this one, they'll probably go directly back onto an eco with how heavily they've invested it this time. Titan, of course, still having the full bite for the most part here coming out from these guys as well. And thankfully with those saves, Hellraisers were able to afford theirs here. So this is going to be that last big attempt. They do shift a much larger presence back than over here towards the B site this time. They're going to get aggressive with it too. Look at them just lining up here. Angel, one, two, three for him. Shox at distance and RpK all already down and dead on the floor here. Smith's trying to watch out for a push coming out from the tunnel, but they're happy with it. They've smoked off the bomb now too. Smith's looking for the spray to at the very least trying to take down Angel, but he's going to reveal himself. Now even he's sitting down at 37 HP, so he's going to be careful about this as well. More pushes, I imagine they might try to close this out in a second, but they really don't even have to do it. kUcheR though accidentally kills Angel by some random chain of events. I don't even know how that happened. And Scream here picks up Oscar as well. So now this puts it into a 2-on-3. Smith is very low. But it's not
there's a flank coming in as well, yeah. So STYKO has a good chance to go ahead and end this here if they don't pick up on this.
Some of these guys push back up here. STYKO looking to try and take down Scream. He almost finishes off, and actually he does manage finishing off there. Smith just barely has a little bit of an angle. It was like a pixel to shoot through. So he takes him down, and now it's all on Scream. Hiding inside the tunnel, very loud, so they know where he is. But he's got the bomb control back in his hands now, too.
You can actually get a plan here.
It's all going to depend on how aggressive Hellraiser is going to play this. So they move out. They afford to pay the price for it, though, as Scream is going to be able to very quickly dispatch of Schneider. Now he's
going to
run
he's
away
going
with
A.
This.
He's got plenty of time to do it, too. Wow. How quickly the tides turn. I thought after that triple kill spray down from Angel, this round was in the bag, but Scream has been able to find a way to play this into a winnable 1v2 with the health he has and the time he has to move around into the bomb play, but he didn't plant for himself, and he's going bathroom, so that could pose a bit of a problem.
Members of Hellraisers, though, pretty much all coming back over there through the tunnels now, working their way back over here towards the top. Scream is expecting a flank, but there isn't one coming back in. It's just going to come directly into his face here. And as you said, this puts him onto an off angle. He's already basically given up control of the bomb, but he leaves it open, picks up one of these kills, and now he pops back in, just finds the second one, too. Takes down STYKO, finishes off the round, and off of the hands of Scream, man. They clutch it back out. Think about how that round started. Hellraisers' Angel just comes in, gets three kills in the first few seconds of the round, and they somehow manage to turn that back into their favor.
There was a couple of rounds like that, though, too, in the first map where Hellraisers had some advantageous rounds and they still wound up forfeiting the round, so that's a little bit of concern there, but what a play from Scream, right? He just plays that perfect. He just kind of, plays patiently. He gets into the B-bomb site since everyone's pushing the construction, and he's able to get the kill and move himself into the A-bomb site. Just, well orchestrated there. Caused some doubt with the way he planted and able to get the frags, and now it's a save for Hellraisers. We see Titan just sweeping through the B-bomb site here, no trouble whatsoever, taking a bit of damage on a couple of players, but still so far a clean round, and it's going to be round number 7 for Titan, and that's just a magical play from Scream. Just what so well done. It was just played perfectly.
Oscar trying to keep himself hidden behind the sandbags, but I'm pretty sure he's not really hidden at this point. They have a feeling somebody's here. All these flashes and whatnot going into his face. Shox will take some heat, but he still manages to pick up the frag. He's already up to 3 with the MAC-10 this time, and now they've just got to find the final player over here. Schneider completely blind in existence. I don't think he really expects him to be up there, but still manages to find the frag anyway. So again, another flawless round comes out from Titan. They're right back on the winning saddle at this point, and can really just start to forge ahead here once again now as they have just plenty of cash. Again, same thing
I'm
as we
still
had.
Just blindsided by that round, man. I don't know how Scream brought that back. That's actually funny that he only has 6 kills this game and 4 of them came from that one round after 9 rounds played, so he was kind of quiet up until that point, but what a bold statement to make to get back into the game for Scream.
So Scream again now, of course, bringing Titan back into this, preventing Hellraisers from making the comeback, but Hellraisers are definitely not out of this game just as of yet. And Oscar, one of the big players here so far from the side of Hellraisers, starts off this round by picking up 1 kill. Splits up Titan a little bit, but still mainly looking to make this push right here into the B side. They've got the bomb with them. Maybe gonna move through Monster Sega, but they do have to get these two players down through Connector and get themselves ready to push into the site. And they've lost control of water too, so you can see both Schneider and Angel are ready to hold off this angle. So that does screw up the plans for Titan a little bit, but as they work their way out, RpK finds one opener. Schneider is able to trade it back out, but even the take on the main site itself is having some trouble. kUcheR finds that kill in a shox. Smith's in Existence finally able to take out some of these guys, but in the 2-on-2, they're gonna look very weak. Existence is at 3 HP. If he crosses back out from construction, he's probably gonna be a dead man. Oskar just might end up pushing this here. Thankfully pulls out the op, but again, gonna win that battle versus Existence anyway, so now it's all on Smith. Comes out, finds his first kill, and now it's very palatable for Titan once again to win things out. Oscar's gonna have to find a way back in. He has no... He's gonna worry about this Molly to expire. He's only got this HE grenade. Smith as well just has a superior angle against him without a smoker. He's gonna wide peek this. Misses the shot. Oscar's gonna slow peek that, and now he has an angle against him here too. But he has to make progress, get himself over to this bomb, looking for it, and Smith pulls out a grenade! So that's gonna be Oscar winning that out. Members of Hellraisers will pick up one more round for themselves, and of course, plenty of time left for that defuse. So that's Hellraisers picking up a third point now.
We were pulling out the nade there. He could have easily just thrown it from behind the wall and not, you know, expose himself. And you got to think that it's probably going to be a tap. So a little bit of a fumble there maybe from Smith, but still well played to even get in that situation. I mean, it looked like Hellraisers was always ahead the way they pushed construction, the picks they were getting. Smith stuck in a 1v2, you know, makes it close, but doesn't quite get it. The miracle doesn't stretch over for another clutch here for Titan. And so Hellraisers finally back on the board. After, you know, having a rough start to the game, finding a couple, and then Titan is coming right back at him with another three-round winning streak, which allows them still plenty of money to afford what they want to do. And you can see they're already pretty committed to be here. And again, Hellraisers committing a lot of numbers to A, so that means there's only going to be two at B to defend against this, with their rotation being pretty far off. And so that's going to give a lot of opportunity for Titan.
So now Titan's slowly creeping in from Monster. They've revealed themselves now, so the take is going to begin. Angel's a good angle, but he's not looking to his left. They find that first kill, but he's immediately traded back out there by RpK. The CT's still holding strong, though. kUcheR finding another kill, hiding back in CT main there. And he's gonna fall back completely in the tunnels in case the members get aggressive. But even this push to come back down through connector, shox is gonna hold this off as well. Finding that kill onto Oskar, takes him out of the play. kUcheR coming back in though, finds the offer, taking down Smith, trying to light up the shot onto one of the final ones, but not gonna happen. And now all the pressure shifts over to STYKO to clutch this out in the 1-on-2. He's got the angle on his shox, but he's ducking down, keeping himself hidden. That nade gonna be absolutely perfect. Brings it down to 45 HP, almost finishing him off. Just playing with him really at this point. Existence, even though he's not really a part of this, has plenty of time to get himself into a good spot to try and hold off the rest of this push. And I think STYKO might just call for a save, considering what he's got to work with at this point.
This, you know, with Hellraisers being so dedicated to A, with three players like committed to an aggression over at Upper Park, it just gives Titan a free bomb site. I have to say, kUcheR put up a great effort with the three frags to kind of buy time for his team to rotate, but shox is there and stares once again to cut off the rotates, like he was doing on Dust 2 at Double Doors, for example. That's kind of a new role for him on this Titan team, and look out for that in the future when you see them playing in leagues and maybe even some LAN tournament play. It seems like shox has moved away from being a primary entry like he was when he first joined this team to being more of kind of a solo man, you know, maybe sometimes lurking or backstabbing, cutting off rotates. They seem to be setting him up for later round situations rather than being the first guy in the site. So that's kind of maybe an interesting change for Titan strategy going forward.
Now these Titan guys again are going to push up. A big push coming in over here towards towards Long A to get themselves onto that site. And for Hellraisers, they've taken the gambit to just put everybody down here to B to resist it, and it doesn't pay off at all. They basically are going to get themselves onto the site for free. Hellraisers won't be able to wrap into this quickly enough. And Smith is even getting aggressive now too. Should be able to take down STYKO. Already got one kill in the bag. They know that a second one's sitting down there, so this hold should go fine. We do have, I believe it's shox, is sort of boxed in at this point, but he's already killed one of these guys. Not expecting the player to his right, so Schneider is going to grab at least one kill off of this one, but very quickly, RpK is coming in. They don't want to allow these players to get these saves coming back out, so Schneider's got that AK. Blind, but he finds that kill anyway over here on RpK in order to take him down. So at the very least, Hellraisers may be able to escape with one AK, but in terms of round take, probably not going to happen. And Oscar's picked up an AK now as well, so this could actually be a very beneficial round, all things speaking economically.
Yeah, I mean, Titan are just finding the holes in Hellraiser's defense, and they're exploiting it. You know, and also the fact that shox is cutting off the rotation so well, Hellraisers aren't able to really respond to it. That's happened at the B-bomb set at least two or three times this game, in fact. So, really good work here from Titan. You know, they haven't really messed around with A really at all. They've been more focused on just doing heavy B executes, and maybe, depending on how things go, they might go to some type of later round A-bomb plant. But, really, just the way they've been able to attack this B-bomb site has been so successful, they really haven't had to do anything else. But this time around, they will be putting most of their forces over here into A, so they are going to go ahead and take a different approach this time around. That's actually one of the only times I've seen them go so heavy. heavy towards the A site. We'll see how it works. As Oscar's going to be alone here at the upper park, and he gets taken care of immediately. No one there to trade, so Titan have a free upper park.
Intel's game, though. He should know that this big push is coming here. Unfortunately, there's still a pretty big chance they can just wrap right back down and go to connector, but they're not doing this. So they can at the very least move Angel back up here to assist with this a little more. But now losing a player to it kind of just throws it by the wayside. They know the take is coming in, though. They hear all the nades rolling back into the site, so it's going to get regrouped here. Styko might find himself out in the open. He can hear Shox coming back in, so should be able to find that kill, but no, not going to be the case. Shox takes him back down. Now the members of Titan, they've got themselves onto this site. The only player that can really initially hold this off would be Angel, as he's sitting right back over here, sitting behind the APC at this point. He's got a smoke to support him, but he's got to keep himself very, very quiet until his teammates get into a better position. If he reveals himself now, might get one kill, but more than likely he's going to be a dead man right after that. And the smoke, unfortunately, fades a little bit too early, so RpK is going to be able to take him down without him finding any frags at all, and these final two from Hellraisers are looking to save now.
Yeah, Schneider trying to save this AK. Shox will push into him, so he'll be able to get that kill. So, that is good at least that they're able to hold onto a couple of rifles here. But Titan here about to move up to 10 rounds on the Terra side of Overpass on a map that was Hellraiser's pick, and a map that Titan doesn't play as much. You'd hope Hellraiser might have a bit of a chance after what you saw on Dust 2, but doesn't seem to be working that way at this point. In fact, if they aren't careful, this game could, you know, this game's probably already kind of gotten out of hand, actually. As far ahead as Titan is, they probably are in great. I mean, it's going to be really hard for Hellraisers to come back, I guess, is my point.
So another full buy, of course, comes out from Titan and Master Hellraisers. It's going to be another awkward buy from them because they've kind of got enough money to buy, but for three players, it's not really in that case here. kUcheR is going to have enough for his M4, but that's it. Stiko's got a Deagle, and that's it. And Oskar, of course, actually gets thrown a Mag 7 by one of his teammates. So he's going to try to use that sitting over here just inside of water in hopes of flying it, but the big push is going to be coming out over here towards connector first. Thankfully, kUcheR's here to support. He finds the first kill on RpK to take him down, but now moving forward, Oskar would have to come out on top here, but he's actually falling back now, so he doesn't really have a good angle to work with this Mag 7. He's going to pull the pistol instead, as the rest of Titan, although they've met some trouble here, they are going to try to change things up and go for the A-take instead.
Yeah, I mean, they tried to force the issue through the door, but it's a double construction push here from Hellraisers. They've been able to trade out very well. It's there. Shox remaining alive for a while, but finally caught by Oskar. An AK collected, and now it's just going to be an A hit, but Angel already in position with the FAMAS. He's going to be able to find Smiths, and that's going to leave existence in a 1v3. And so Hellraisers, here towards the end of the half, might finally find themselves another round to put on the board.
Existence creeping back up here, looking for one of these frags, but not going to be able to find it. Oskar with a quick shutdown. Hellraisers now find another point finally as we go into the final round. This will be their last big chance to really try to scavenge something out of this half. As you said before, this is already an absolutely monstrous one for Titan. If they pick up an 11th point, it's going to be even better so. But if Hellraisers can swing back and get a 5th point, I would say it's recoverable at that point. But very, 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 very on the edge of it being recoverable, unfortunately.
Yeah, it would be really relying on whether or not they can get a pistol going in the second half at this point, regardless of what happens this round. Titan's been able to show the ability to play a pretty good CT side in some of the overpass games I have seen them play on this. Usually at least good for 7 or 8 rounds, which would be more than enough in this situation. So yeah, Hellraisers really needs to win out this round. They really need the pistol in the second half as well. But we're going to see them have a double op set up here on Hellraisers, so they're trying to defend. kUcheR again coming up big with the initial defense at B.
kUcheR gets that nice spray transfer there, picks up two and almost finds a third here too, brings RpK down to 25 HP, but he's actually going to be the one to win it. Not only this, but he finds another kill this time. Stiko trades him back out, but there's Existence finding another one for Titan. That puts it down to a 2-on-2. Oscar's waiting for the pop from Construction though, so he's going to be able to take down Shox. Now you've just got Existence. He's going to try and find this, but no, that flick from Oskar ends the half in the favor once again. Seal of Titan, but at the very least, Hellraisers, they find a 5th point, and now bring it up to 10-5 to end things here in their first half.
Oscar's op has been looking impressive today, despite Hellraiser's results being a bit mixed. I mean, they had the win against Greyface, but struggling here against Titan, he's looked good. He's had some really impressive kind of flashy kills with that op on several different occasions throughout the day today. And he came up big in that round as well to hold off in that 2v2 that Titan had made for themselves. So, well done, but again, they really need this pistol round to have a really good shot at coming back into this. So, a lot weighs on what takes place in this 16th round.
So here we go, immediately going into the second half now, as we'll try to see if Hellraisers can recover things on their T side now of Overpass. Working their way up here through connector here, very quickly getting themselves over here towards short A and then making a push into the A site, but I think Titan may expect this. They've got a lot of presence lurking around here. It's definitely still some more down in B, but they've got a lot on a very, very short rotate timer too, so they're going to be able to come if they spot this coming. Even a whiff of this will draw all that attention from Titan, and they're going to have this now as they all roll back in there. Smith takes some heat. He's already down to 9 HP. He's going to fall back over there towards long A. Existence finds the first real kill here, but Schneider is going to respond in kind by taking out Smith. Stiko pushes through the semi, finds Existence, but there's RpK again. So far, evenly traded 2 for 2, but there's RpK finding another 2 kills back-to-back, only leaving Angel left alive from the side of Hellraisers, and RpK is even going to find that one as well. So that's a 4K from RpK, and Titan will pick up the pistol here.
Yeah, I mean, I think this is a good moment to really talk about RpK for just a second. I mean, obviously, when he came back to this team, people didn't really maybe expect a whole lot from him. I mean, he hadn't been playing for a long time. He had been retired since the very early days of CSGO. He's obviously kind of a Counter-Strike Source legend, but it seems like from watching him these past few events and watching his online play recently, you can really see him picking up his form a lot more lately. Like, he's starting to just be a more of a factor in the fragging of this team. And that's really good news to have him come up when you still have Shox being a great player and Scream being back added to the team as well. That's a good little fragging trio there for the team.
So once again now, these guys over here from the side of Hellraiser is going to try to look for a response, and they find it early in the round at the least here, but they've been hit with some pretty heavy damage. Not only this too, but Smith's been just around the corner here, but not actually going to be that successful with that kind of play. Angel takes him down pretty quickly too. Hellraiser get themselves onto the site, not going to have the play going for the result just yet, but I imagine they can soon. But now Scream's here, he's moved back in, drawing all this attention, and RpK just rolls into the site. Shox coming onto the flank too, dispatch the final two, and although that was looking good for Hellraiser at the beginning of it, Titan line up very good angles in order to shut things down before it gets out too far out of hand.
Yeah, and early in the round, Titan kind of put himself on islands. You know, Smith's kind of isolated over there inside long A, being able to get picked up without anyone in a position to trade. And so that got very dangerous. But then RpK comes in with the M4, finds a couple of kills, finally tilts it back in Titan's favor, and Shox kind of puts the exclamation point on the round, so to speak. And there you have it. Titan up now 12-3. Hellraiser's pretty much on a complete save. They will, again, try pushing in the fountain right off the bat, but Existence pushed up with the P90. Already gets the bomb down and finds the second kill also.
Now Existence just unleashing hell right now with the P90. Easy frags left and right. Up the three. Scream finding the fourth. And Schneider hanging out just outside of the tunnels right now. Hoping to maybe pick up something at the very least or sneak his way onto the site. But he's going to run into his opponents pretty quickly. And Smith will pick up the fifth and final frag for Titan and now set them up to 13 points. Just three more away. We'll see the first gun run coming out here from Hellraisers. And this is really going to be one of their last big chances. They'll have this one and probably the 15th point to really try to strike back. And if not, then Titan are going to run over it. They'll pick up map number two and they'll end this set 2-0.
Yeah, absolutely. That was kind of the big thing we talked about was Hellraisers needed to try to close that last round of the first half. They did, but the second big factor they needed to have a good shot at coming back into this was, you know, getting the pistol this half, and they have it. They get the 0-3 start in the half, and now Titan has a massive lead. We do see Titan being a bit conservative here. They're not upgrading. They're keeping two of their umps as well as a P90, so they only have two rifles in play, and one of them's a FAMAS, but look, a Scream getting super aggressive at Monster. Gets the kill, gets the information, and not gathered up outside B, unless they're construction, but Shox is there to deal with that, and so they're just getting the kills and so much intel.
We'll see here, STYKO 2 looking to maybe try to find some response fights to this one. Lines up one kill in RpK at the very least. But now the members of Hellraisers looking for a way to get themselves onto that A site too, and actually it's pretty free at this point. Shox does find a very nice kill, as we could see there on a STYKO in order to take him down, but in the long run of things, all this is going to do is make this round go pretty much completely into the favor of Titan now. Creature's here, but can't hold on to it. Shox shuts him down, and on the way back to retrieve that bomb, which was probably one of the bigger mistakes, they could have at the very least had a plan here, and this could have allowed them to have a pretty competent buy going at round number 20 here, where Titan would sit at 14 points, but now that they actually had to go back and get the bomb, and they no longer have site control to secure themselves a plant, you know, more than likely this bomb isn't going to end up getting planted now, but actually, has Oskar completely flanked everybody on this team?
Yeah, he could get a plant if he plants for a bank or something like that, because the flank is coming in bathrooms, and it just depends on the speed at which he gets in the site. But yeah, now there's already a rotate as well coming in, so he won't be able to get in there. And so Titan gets the kill, and the Titan's just styling on him at this point, man. They didn't upgrade a single gun. They went up against a full AK buy with two wumps, a P90, a FAMAS, and one M4, but they just push everything. You know, they push long. They get a kill, they cut off any type of sandbags aggression with Shox's ump, and I mean, they're just overwhelming Hellraisers in this game. I mean, even that disadvantageous situations, they're winning. And here we see a force from Hellraisers to try to see if they can't hold Titan off from map point, but this is really their last chance.
And of course, as we see in the hour, they're just gonna force this up as much as they possibly can here. And already you've got Schneider looking to move in against Smith here as he's hiding inside of that smoke. Won't be able to catch him just as of yet, and Smith's even quiet as a mouse back over there inside of that corner. He's gonna wait for his opponent to push into him or for the smoke to fade. That pop flash comes in but doesn't really hit him, and now all that waiting for nothing, unfortunately. STYKO is gonna be able to take him back down before any more damage can be done. We see as well here, good entry being made by the members of Hellraisers. They get themselves onto the A site too, and that's going to draw the rotate. Good thing, because that's where the bomb is being played, but the bomb not really being committed. It's still sitting way back over there at the top of long A. And the Scream works his way back in. He's going to have a nasty surprise waiting for him in the form of kUcheR, but he's able to handle it. Takes out kUcheR, and now they've got to try to draw that bomb back and get it onto the B site instead.
Yeah, it's going to be hard. It's got a long rotate through. They have pushed two players through B to try to backstab the CTs here, but RpK has picked up on it here. Already with Runfrag, Oskar is bringing that bomb through the stairs. He's trying to get over to B. He knows that his team has control, but how long can they actually hold it? As time ticks away, shox and RpK begin to position themselves to get back into B. RpK gets caught in the back, however, by that aggression from Angel. So there's a real good shot here and their last chance to maybe make this happen, but shox gets the kill back into a 2-on-2.
Comes in there, picks up that nice little headshot. Angel's waiting for it back inside the pit. He's going to line up a nice headshot as well. Takes down shox. And now it's on screen once again. He's already just sitting up on top of A, so it'd actually be pretty ballsy for him to go for this retake because he doesn't really know what's going on right now. But again, I guess he's just going to try to eat it back up here. His Titan has such a big lead, they can try to go for it here. Good nade comes in. Brings Oskar on 30 HP. He's going to be able to take him down, but takes a heavy risk in it. Now he's down at 6 HP. Looking for Angel. Almost takes him down, and he's going to do it. Wow. There. Wait. Oh, I thought he was going to take fall damage there for a second. But
that would have been great. That would have been the most glorious thing we've seen all day if he would have died right there. But what a smart play from Scream. Not really sure where Angel is. He tosses a pistol and baits Angel shots out, and then finds out exactly where he is, and he's able to make the peak. So that was just another brilliant play from Scream. He's had two really, really clutch plays this game, despite the fact that he's, I guess, towards the bottom end of the scoreboard. He's made some really, really critical plays like that one this game to really help Titan out in a big way. And obviously, shox had a monster game, right? He's almost at 30. I think he's like the new in-game leader for the team, according to what we heard at the SIVO finals just a couple of weeks ago, and that might also be why he's kind of went more to a lurker type position. That also doesn't really favor him to still entry frag if he's going to be calling, but they look sharp this game, that's for sure.
And again, Hellraisers get the buy. It's actually a little better from Hellraisers this time than it was in the previous round, but still, now Titan just have this huge 10 round lead, and even with, you know, any advantage they gain, even if we see them picking up a couple of rounds here, it's not going to secure anything for a while. So Hellraisers again, right. And even if they mount this huge comeback, 10 rounds perfectly from this point forward, they still have to worry about overtime as well. So, you know, the over surmounting odds against Hellraisers right now might just be the victory for Titan in itself here, as Hellraisers may just sort of give up at a certain point and allow Titan to take that 16th round. Is just going to be so hard to do it. But thankfully, at least in this round, they're doing pretty well. Pick up two kills. So far, none else being traded out here. And they've got the location on shox, so they should be able to take him down. But nope, that flight comes back in there, and Existence is going to cut him down. Kucher quick on to find a trade there, so he's going to be able to take down shox. But again, Existence here, finding another one and another one. But now the flank for the flight comes in there. Schneider shuts down Existence, and again, if there will be a clutch, it will come from Scream. So we'll see what he can do.
He's already got two this game, so we'll see if he can come up with another one here. 1v2. Oh, no. Well, I guess he didn't.
All right.
Really great attempt there from Scream, but unfortunately for him, it sped up. You know, didn't really even have a chance at it.
This is heavy, Doc.
You know what I wonder? I guess I shouldn't say it on stream. I'll tell you after what I think the problem is. Come on, we all know. Yeah. Here's what I think. Well, you know, like how the lag usually happens in the last round of the game,
yeah,
or whatever.
Yeah, that's just the lag. That's the lag.
So I guess this is the last round of the game. It's just happening earlier than it's supposed to. Okay. Well, I didn't know if that's what it was.
I think
or not.
That we have, if I remember, I think we have like a 2-minute delay on the Go TV. So
maybe
I don't know. Like, because I don't know if that skip is counting like the end of the previous round too, which would make it make sense, but. We'll see. At least
I don't know. We'll find out.
It would make
sense. If Titan wins this round, then we've figured it out. Billy. I don't know why I called you Billy.
Why would you call me Billy?
I have no clue.
There's like no relation to any of
I thought that was like a movie quote, but I got the wrong name anyway. So I just double messed up.
Alright. So.
Back to you now, Bob. There, I got that one right.
So Titan will look to hold things off here. What's probably the final round. And indeed, looks like it's the case here, as it's three kills so far, two more traded back out by the members of Hellraisers. Angel finding one on two Existence here, gets just another one, so he might have a chance, but we've already spoiled it.
Even yeah, we ruined this for everyone.
People already know. So there you have it, 16-6 on map number two. The final score of the set is going to be 2-0 for Titan. Hellraisers, unfortunately, not going to be able to pick up a map, like we said before. Too big of an advantage in favor of Titan as we got sort of towards the end of things. And that is going to give them the second map and the set for today's match.
Yeah, I'm a terrible human. That's all I can really say there. Sorry for ruining it for you guys there. And hashtag Billy in the chat, so people liked it at least. But yeah, I mean, it was a dominant series from Titan through and through. We already kind of summed up Dust2 when we were moving over to this map. And in this situation, Titan just got off to a rolling start there on the Terra side. Had a series of winning streaks. You know, Hellraisers only found a round here or there. Kept getting their money reset. having a lot of different force buy situations happen, and it was really just Titan mowing them over, especially with their heavy B executes. It seemed like Hellraisers could never really find consistent success on defending against that, and once we saw Titan flip to the CT side on winning pistol, they just never really looked back, you know, held their sights well, and secured the series 16-6 here on Overpass, 2-0 the set, and they'll be the winners here.
And that is going to close out our European games for today, guys. So thank you all very much for tuning in. We have some North American ones coming up in approximately, if I remember correctly, like about 4 hours from now. Should be starting around 9 p.m. Eastern time, 6 p.m. Pacific. So if you want to tune into those, it'll be right here on this channel. Be sure to go and subscribe if you've liked what you've seen, or at the very least, toss us a follow. And once again, my name is Blue. I've been your host. Joining me today was Dust. Our apologies. My name is Billy, apparently. So thank you for joining in. And Dust was with me, otherwise known as Carl.
Blue Billy? Yeah, Billy Blue? I don't know. Billy Blue has a nice ring to it. Maybe you should consider it.
That's not my name. My name is John. If you're going to call me anything,
I know,
call me by my real name.
Mullen. Yeah. Mullen. Right?
So, gotcha, man. If you want to follow us...